Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam amma ba'da. Habita fillah, one of our brothers from India, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him and preserve him, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite our brotherhood, unite us based on the book of Allah and the sunnah, the message of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, instead of always having these barriers. It amazes me when we look at the racism in our community as Muslims, how much racism and hatred we have for one another. For example, if someone is of a particular race and someone brings another person of another race as a proposer of their daughter, that some people would scream, yell, pull their hair out, and you know, it causes travesty. But Ahl Sunnah Haqiqi, meaning that they are really Ahl Sunnah and they are really practicing the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they're not really concerned about that. They're concerned about the person's religion. So this is very imperative. Yes, we have our preferences, and we have this and we have that, but it's very important to try our best to destroy racism within our community. Getting back to the issue, the brother asked, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve us and preserve him, I mean, ya Rabbil Alameen. He asked about seeking knowledge in India. And he said that he is a person who doesn't have the ability to travel. Is it in, and that there are some, I think he said, students of knowledge where he is or something similar to this. And he asked about advice and about seeking knowledge online. And I've said this countless times, as our ulama has spoken about this in countless occasions. Atlab al-ilm, however you can. Whatever path that you can seek knowledge, if you're unable to travel, then seek knowledge where you are. And you can do that as long as you have a internet connection. It's open. And so it's very important for us to use the path that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. As you know, talab al-ilm faridatun ala kulli muslim wa muslima. Seeking knowledge is an obligation upon every Muslim man and Muslim woman. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Man salaka tariqan yaltalmasuhu bihi ilman sahalallahu tariqan ila jannah." Whoever traverses the path of knowledge, Allah will make easy for him the path of paradise. So, striving to gain the path to paradise, Allah is going to make that easy for you one way or another. He's not going to cut you off from the path of good. So you do, ittaqullaha mastata'tum, fear Allah as much as you can. Strive as much as you can. Tawakkal ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah will open that up for you, for you to be able to study His religion and learn and benefit, because there's benefit all over the world. And there's benefit, like I said, that you can learn just from being in the through the internet. And as you mentioned, you're in India, although it's huge, if you want to call it the subcontinent or what have you, India's huge, and there are many scholars in India, and so I would advise that you make a journey and strive to atlab al-ilm in India. That you make the effort to gain knowledge right there in your land. Because, as I mentioned, it's well known for hadith scholarship in places like India and Pakistan. And well known, Ahl Hadeeth wa ghayrihim. And there are ulama, you could ask if you can get in contact with students of Sheikh Wasi Allah Abbas, or talk to the Sheikh himself. He knows Urdu, Arabic, English even. Walillah alhamd. And he's an alim. And if you could get a hold of him and find out where and who to go, then I would advise doing that somewhere in India and gain that immense benefit. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.